great Nigerian workers. Great, great, great Nigerian workers. I am very delighted to be in your midst today as one of the special guests for the 2023 May Day Rally. As you all know, this is the last May Day that is being organized here, and which will be attended by members of the district administration, especially myself as your Labour Minister, me and my staff. So we bring you felicitations from the Federal Ministry of Labour, myself, the Minister of State, and our Permanent Secretary, who is also here with us. It is important that we go a little bit to know why we are here today. Today is First May. This was the day when, in 1886, some workers in Illinois, Chicago, in the Haymarket Square, decided to go on strike. 3 days after that, on May 4, they were hurled down and bombed. Most of them lost their lives. Very few escaped. So it is in that spirit that workers all over the world have decided that today will be International Workers' Day. And Nigeria is not an exception. The government of Shehu Shagari instituted this day as the May Day. I think when that was when Congress Nasser Somon was at the helm of affairs. So I would like to use the opportunity to welcome all of you to this particular ceremony. And before I proceed or continue, I want to again reiterate and clear the air on the little miscommunication that happened that necessitated an agency of the FCT trying to cancel an earlier approval for the ministry's ground. Of course, immediately the minister got to know, the very senior comrade and your very good friend, he was very angry, and of course he nullified immediately the demotion of him. I would also like to use this opportunity to officially congratulate the Trade Union Congress of Nigeria, the Nigerian Labour Congress, on your successful National Delegate Conference a few months ago, especially that of the NLC, which produced a new leader in Comrade Joe Ajaero to replace our ebullient, hardworking, immediate past president, President Comrade Ayub Awawa. I fervently hope and pray that your tenors will witness remarkable strides that will take organized labor to higher level. The little skirmishes in one of the centers, I believe by now, would have been a thing of the past. I would also like to thank the two centers for choosing a fit and proper team for this year's celebration. That team is Workers' Rights and Socioeconomic Justice. This team, not only is it up, but there is a need for us to take stock of all our efforts and collective responsibility in promoting the decent work agenda of the IAU, which in the main seeks to ensure decent wages, boosting of the disposable incomes of Nigerian workers generally, improving job security, facilitation and provision of conducive workplaces, establishing and expanding and strengthening the social safety net, and closing the widening income gap and inequality in job remuneration. Comrades and distinguished guests, the federal government of Nigeria recognizes the importance of Nigerian workers. And we are committed, and have been committed since we came on board, to creating the right environment for them to thrive in the past 2 years. In this respect, we are taking a number of measures, which is not limited to, but include, review, and increase of the national minimum wage in the year 2019 from 15,000 naira a month to 30,000 naira a month. Not only was this done, there was the institutionalization of an automatic review of the minimum wage every 5 years in the Act. We have, as a government, also provided better working conditions and environment than we met when we came. We have also invested in training and retraining, education, and human capacity development for Nigerian workers, especially those in the public sector. We have also encouraged toolmaker, the employers in the private sector to do same. However, we recognize that there is a lot of more work to be done to improve the lives of Nigerian workers. We acknowledge the fact that many Nigerian workers continue to face significant challenges, which includes low take-home pay, lack of job security, unsatisfactory working conditions, to name a few. Comrades, we are committed as a government to addressing the issues that we are addressing and try to create a more favorable environment for you. The solution to these challenges will then be found in one way, the answer is no. You can't find the answer as a solution with these challenges overnight. This is why we have made a top priority in the agenda of that great administration, and we intend to bring them to the coming administration with a work plan for addressing them as governments in their continuity. To this end, I'm glad to announce to you that the Muhammad Buhari administration has done so many initiatives and programs. I can go on and on for a few of these programs. Especially for the young people, and National Enterprise Development Program, the Youth Entrepreneurship Support Program, with accompanying funds, the Nigerian Social Investment Fund and Program, the National Technology Development Program. All these programs were designed to create jobs. Job creation is multi-sectoral and not confined to only the minister or ministry of labor. It is also to be recalled that since the emergence of the consolidated wage structure in Nigeria, we have about 12 wage structures. But a particular wage structure, the consolidated public service salary structure, comes for short, have been on the table and have not been reviewed by any of the past administrations. For any wage increase, the only wage increase they experienced was the consequential minimum wage adjustment of 2019 for all wage structures under this government in 2019. However, in line with the earnings and aspirations of Nigerian workers, and the need to harmonize the earning powers of Nigerians, the federal government recently worked out the introduction of 40% peculiar allowance into the remuneration and the emolument of all federal civil and public servants on the corps wage structure to help cushion the effects of inflation and other costs of doing their work, as they are not on any special allowance. This demonstration of good faith shows that government can commit
to an improvement of your working condition, even without any industrial action or strike. But there's a fallout of social dialogue. However, these workers have gotten the wedding to 40%, with a 3 months or arrears from January 2023, as captured in the 23 appropriation. However, other workers in the different wage structures, like in the consolidated health service structure, consolidated medical service structure, consolidated university academic structure, counties, consolidated structure, and all other structures that have started collective bargaining agreement with their direct employer are hereby enjoined to fast forward and fast track the initiating of the collective bargaining agreement so that the CBA will be transmitted immediately to the National Salaries Incomes and Wages for onward treatment by the Presidential Committee on Salary. All these structures are so mentioned have the wage increases and adjustment waiting for them to collect because they are the 2023 appropriation of the federal government. The people of Cornwall and other wage structures of SANU, National Academic Staff Union Universities and Tertiary Institutions, the money has been packaged at a 350 billion in the 2023 appropriation that have been passed by the National Assembly and accepted to by Mr. President. So the ball is in your court. If you do it in 1 week, the President Committee on Salaries, we are sitting now every week, it will be done and you collect your money. But if you want to tarry, you can tarry. It's money safe for you because it is already captured in the appropriation. Similarly, this government, in a way to cushion the effect of wage earning families, have invested a lot in the social investment and poverty alleviation programs. These programs are for the vulnerable persons, and the national cash register of poor and vulnerable Nigerians now exists with assistance of the World Bank. It has been done by the Ministry of Internal Affairs. And that 2.6% from more than 7 million poor and vulnerable households identified across 7 to 8 local governments have been captured. Nothing precludes workers' families from being part of this enumeration. Under the National Social Housing Program of again, Nigerians, especially workers, will be given houses. And these have been facilitated by the Central Bank with a loan. And state governments have related lands. So in 24 states, this social housing working program is working. Enugu, Kano, Delta, and Nasarawa, at least for now, have completed their own program and beneficiaries are going to their new homes. There is also the Finnish program on housing. They have known by the Office of the Head of Civil Service of the Federation. This scheme is also operated mainly for civil servants to own their own home. Work in progress, but commissions of homes in the suburbs of Abuja and residents and Nigerian workers. In the field of agriculture, same have been done. Agriculture, farming is the only trade, occupation allow for civil servants and public servants to engage in, apart from the work they are doing, captured in the essential of the Nigerian Constitution. So nothing stops a worker from establishing a new farm, no matter how small the farm is. We also have the Presidential Fertilizer Initiative, which is to assist farmers, which workers can be part of. As we celebrate today's Workers' Day, it is important that we remember the millions of Nigerian workers who have dedicated their lives to building and sustaining our communities. We have to recognize their contributions, acknowledge the challenges that they face, the workers face every day, because the workers are the producers in the economy. So we have to, apart from mental sacrifices, try to do justice to the Nigerian workers. As we remember the people who have come, we want to remember in Nigeria particularly the coal miners that were shot, just like the Chicago workers. These other workers were shot in the Uber Valley. Uber protests with their foreign lawyers, colonial masters. We have so many people here who have dedicated their lives working for the benefit of Nigerian workers. Some are still alive, and some are not here in their life. Michael Imodo, labor leader number one, is one of them. And then many other people like Pascal Bafion, we all remember all of them today. Finally, comrades, workers, comrade president, and the members of the executive, I implore all of you to consolidate on the mileage already covered by the federal government in the last 8 years. Ensure agreement, fashionalization, selfishness, and develop a spirit of cooperation rather than confrontation, and engage in social dialogue rather than aggression or necessary industrial action with your employers. Social dialogue is an elixir that will engender industrial peace, engender mutual trust, and strengthen and consolidate the unity needed to build a prosperous and egalitarian nation of our dream. Great Nigerian workers, in closing, I want to say a heartfelt thank you to all of you for your hard work, dedication, and commitment to our nation, and for the cooperation we receive from you with the Federal Ministry of Labor and Employment for the 8 years that was on Saturday. On behalf of the Nigerian government and my ministry, I wish you all a happy and prosperous Workers' Day. Thank you and God bless the Federal Government. Solidarity! Thank you very much.